watch me get a brand new visor, yeah. Your friend smart, but my butt's wiser, yeah. Get the job done like the equalizer. And I'ma grab another drink, cause tonight I'ma die. I feel like Michael Phelps, hey, diving in his pool.
Just a gorgeous fall afternoon in the heart of Texas. No weather to speak of. Sun out, roof open. Yes, yes, and yes. A great day for football at AT&T Stadium in Arlington. Obviously, they do everything big here in Dallas, and the introduction of the Cowboys, no exception. They're set for football in Big D, as their guys will do battle with Ben Roethlisberger and the Pittsburgh Steelers. And this will go as a touchback, and they will begin things at the 25. James Conner, and just no chance of turning the corner. He can only get back to the line of scrimmage. Second and 10 coming up.
Gain on the play. Second and 10 at the 25-yard line.
So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. From the shotgun, it's Roethlisberger. That'll be taken in there by James Washington. He'll be dropped after a gain of about six across the 30 to the 31. They get six. That'll leave them with third and four.
And it's third down.
And they'll look to avoid an early three and out here on third and four. From the gun, a give to Conner. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. That burst good for 20 and a first down. So from Cowboy territory now, here's first and 10 at the 49-yard line. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. A good gain again. That's now 31 yards combined on those last two plays. On first down, Conner going to be lucky to get back to the line of scrimmage, and that's all.
Brought down right at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play.
Now they'll throw it with Roethlisberger.
At the Cowboys, 30.
And now he'll tuck it and run.
And him running the football is not something that defenses spend a lot of time preparing for. But this guy has a survival instinct and a knack for knowing when exactly to do it.
Looked ready for that third down pass. Brings up fourth.
Well, they've got man coverage on the outside, and my scouting report on these DBs tells me that they love to take matters in their own hands. They want man coverage, not zone. And there was good coverage there that forced the incompletion.
And able to haul it in is Kittle. And down to the 20 he'll go before heading out of bounds. A big pickup of 12 yards on fourth down to keep this drive from stalling. From the red zone now, here's Roethlisberger on first down. Completion here to Claypool. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. A gain of six there on first.
Brings up second and four at the Cowboys.
On second down, it's Connor. And for a second straight play, that Cowboy defense gets him to the ground behind the line of scrimmage. It'll be a loss of a couple on the play, so now third down coming up. It's been a pretty long opening drive. This will be play number 11 coming up on third down. Here's Roethlisberger. Looking end zone, but it's incomplete.
Normally being a big-bodied receiver plays to their advantage downfield. Go up and make the catch, take the hit, and pick up yardage. But in this case, the hit was timed really well and popped it free from his grasp.
Now the defense going to use the first of their timeouts. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Prescott of the Cowboys now with a first and 10 at their own 24. They run it for the first time with Tony Pollard. And he'll take it forward for about five up to the 28-yard line. Ball carrier.
He was a quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent game.
It's a gain of five. Brings up second and five at the 28-yard line.
From the 28, it's second and five. From the shotgun, it's Prescott. On the crossing route, he hits his man, Amari Cooper. And he gets this to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out. A gain of 28 yards there and give him a first down. Operating out of Steeler territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 44-yard line. Looking for more there on first down, but this throw downfield, incomplete. The rookie CeeDee Lamb, the intended receiver. That'll bring up second down. Prescott looking for Jeffrey, and it's intercepted, picked off by Kiko Alonso, and he will return this one to the 30-yard line. Charles, that makes now five interceptions and not even five quarters. Remember, he threw four picks last week.
And this turns into a tough situation because a lot of fans, the first thing is, oh, well, we need to change quarterbacks. This is your guy. This is your elite player. You can't just take him out like that. If I'm the coach, I make a little joke and say, you know something, you've got him. We're going to change the football. So it's obvious that's the problem. It's not you. Keep firing.
A good run there on first down, and it'll leave him with a second and two.
On the pickup. Brings up second and two.
He's got the first down and more past midfield. And finally brought down at the 43. That one good for a first down pickup of 18 yards. On first and 10 is Connor. And he'll be brought down at about the 42. No score after one on EA Sports. The last run got a couple. Here's second and 8. Play fake to Connor. Now Roethlisberger. That's complete to his running back, Connor. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. It's a first down on a gain of 10.
First down.
From the 32 now. Here's first and 10. Play action. It's Roethlisberger. And he's going to be taken down. Pressure gets there back at the 39-yard line. Well, they go play fake. The problem is nobody was faked out.
And when no one's faked out, what's the end result? Sad. Quarterback gets hit.
Now, following the sack, they'll look to make amends on a second down and 17. Now, Roethlisberger. He'll get that one complete to Connor. A good pickup there. 13 yards as they get closer for third down. The Steelers on third down. Just 1 for 3 thus far. This is 3rd and 4. Looking for his running back, and he's got him. And he gets this down to the 18. Good enough for a first down. 8 yards, first down, as they're able to convert. They go play action here on first down. Got his man. It's caught for a Steelers touchdown.
Number 11,
Chase Claypool. His 4th touchdown on the year. As his guys are first onto the scoreboard here this afternoon. And partner, they found a gap there on the post pattern, and it was in the middle third of the field.
And that's really difficult to do because ordinarily the safeties are back there to prevent that happening. But they found the opening and exploited it.
Boswell now to kick it away after the touchdown. Taking it about the 1. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line.
On the return, the Cowboys take over first and 10 at their own 30-yard line.
The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. And, Charles, if the season ended today, and it's not going to, we still have December
Yay,
left.
More football.
We're only in November. But they would be a wild card team. And that's great. They'd be in the playoffs, but you know they're trying to bump up to be one of those division leaders.
That guarantees you at least one home game in the playoffs, and that's what you're really seeking. But there also isn't much margin for error for this team, right? Because right where they're sitting, a 2-game losing streak could have them out of the playoffs. So they've got to make sure they continue to keep the momentum going.
Absolutely. There's some sharks smelling blood in the water behind them. Now this throw caught left side. The 20. Touchdown, Cowboys. Terry McLaurin, his 4th touchdown on the year. And the Cowboys are an extra point away from tying the football game. So Dak will bring the Cowboys up to go for the 2-point try. They get this out left, and he will get into the end zone to extend the lead by 2 more.
Cowboys 8, Steelers 7.
Now after the touchdown, it's Zuerlein. He'll kick it away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback.
25-yard line.
The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there. All right. I need you to check my eyes here. This entire unit defensively, I think, has looked really strong in the first half, especially in the secondary. They've been cohesive, fast to the football. We just saw another example arriving there to help knock that one away.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Play action. Now Roethlisberger. Throw left side complete. That's Connor. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds. 16 yards, a first down.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
Roethlisberger going to get this one to Connor. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8. Second and 2.
Complete to James.
Facing a second and 2 after that last catch. Good for 8 yards.
Second and 2 at their 49-yard line.
To throw again is Roethlisberger. Stepping up, he'll try and run. And he'll be brought down at the 45-yard line.
Roethlisberger on the keeper.
2 minutes even in what's been a tight first half. 8-7, our score.
First down, Pittsburgh.
Coming up at halftime, I'll go from one personality, that's you, Charles Davis, to another one in Orlando, the coach. He'll have stats and scores from around the NFL. You and Jonathan Coachman, both larger than life.
No doubt about it.
But you're stuck with me in this booth.
Yes,
and he's
I
miles
am.
Away and smiling.
And happy.
Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Anthony Brown. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
The Cowboys take over first and 10 at their own 16-yard line.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do?
Now the pressure comes and he goes down. Just inside the 10, back at the 9. Matt Judon, able to record his 5th sack of the season. Don't need it all back at once, but you figure they're going to need something here. 17 yards to go on second down. Slings this deep from McLaurin. And this one taken in on the right sideline, but not in the field of play. They say it's incomplete. The throw led him a little too far. It brings up third down.
Third down and 17.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Out of the gun. Here's Prescott. And way up past the 35 before he's taken down. How about that? They weather the storm of a third and 17 to pick up the first.
Well, sometimes our pregame meetings do pay off, don't they? What did the guys in the locker room call him?
Well, they said it with a chuckle. They called him Old Reliable.
Yeah, that means he doesn't move quite as fast as he used to, but he still knows all the tricks, doesn't he? Even that little gentle push-off in order to get open, he finds a way to pick up a first down.
Now the Cowboys are going to burn the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with a little over 30 seconds to go in the first half of play. So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. From the red zone now, Prescott. Escaping the pressure right. He's going to take off with it. And he can't quite get there. Tackled down at the 1. The escapability in evidence there is that one. Good for 15 in the first. The Cowboys going to use their second timeout now, as it'll come with 15 seconds to play in the first half. Looks like a jumbo set with 3 tight ends here for first and goal. Now here's Pollard. And he will take it in for a Cowboy score. Tony Pollard, as the first half is winding down. And the Cowboys will add on to their lead. CD for them. This has just been an offensive explosion here in the second quarter.
Yeah, held scoreless in the first quarter. Now they find the end zone again here in the second. Sometimes you just have to have some patience. A lot of people think it's always an adjustment. You have to change what you're doing. Sometimes you just have to do your game plan just a little bit better. And I think that's part of what we're seeing here.
And this will be a touchback as Ed sails over the end line.
25-yard line.
The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
And with just 4 seconds left in this first half, a timeout call. The big play to start him out has him at the 45 already. Final play of the half. It's Roethlisberger going top shelf for Smith-Schuster. Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Obi Melifonwu. And he will be brought down as time is now run out on this first half of action. So we have reached halftime here in what's an 8-point game. As we send you on over to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman in our EA Sports halftime report. Take it away, Coach. The Cowboys will get the football first here, and they have the lead as well as we are underway in quarter three. Taking it about the one. And the tackle going to be made right there at the 25-yard line.
First and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing, because that drive went and went. No adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. 12 yards there and a first down. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Flush to his right. That's complete to his receiver, McLaurin. And he is brought down, but not before reaching the 30. Call that a very strong gain of 24. Operating out of Steeler territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 30-yard line. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by Steven Nelson. And a great return as they're finally able to take him down. So it was a drive that had real promise here to begin the third quarter, but ultimately derailed by the INT.
And that was the position you wanted to be in, coming out to start this third quarter, get a nice drive going, looking for the end zone. Possibly got a little bit too greedy right there.
So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10. It's Connor as they stay on the ground. And he'll take this one up to about the 23. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it second and 4. You know, despite the scoreline, I think they've got to like where they are here. They're on the road and just one big play away from getting right back in this game.
I'm going to follow right along with you, because the spot they're in now is a credit to their defense. They've kept them in it by making the plays that they've made, and that just means you're one big score away from being right back there.
Now, the question is, can this offense step up and make that play? Because that's been an issue for them in this game. They only get two there, but on third and one, that's all they needed to keep the drive alive. Here's Roethlisberger to throw. Stepping up, he's going to keep it. He'll get 8 on the scramble there. It'll be second and a couple.
8 yards on the pickup. Brings up second and 2.
Throwing again on second down. Roethlisberger. And he's going to find his man out of the backfield. That's complete. And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. They'll get three as the drive continues. It's a first down.
Steelers.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Out of the gun, it's Roethlisberger. And the Cowboys' pressure gets there this time for the sack. Michael Pierce, in all of his 340-pound glory, gets the sack.
It's second down.
So now 20 yards to go on second down after the sack. Work to be done. Roethlisberger will throw. He's going to sling this. He's got a man complete. And he is finally out of bounds all the way down at the 30. It's a big play there for the Steelers. 41 yards. So the big play has him all the way down to the 30 now for first and 10. Roethlisberger. Pressure applied, and he's going to be taken down. They sack him back at the 33-yard line. A good response by the defense, sending them backwards after that huge gain last play. This one into the hands of Kittle, the tight end. And he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10. 23 yards the pickup there.
23 yards.
On first down, it's Roethlisberger. This will be caught at about the 6. And he's in. Touchdown, Steelers.
Derek Watt.
His first touchdown on the year. And the Steelers are within a 2-point conversion of tying this game. Now Mike Tomlin says, let's go ahead and go for two. From the gun, it's Roethlisberger. And he'll get into the end zone, and those 2 points are going to tie the game.
Chris Boswell to kick off for Pittsburgh.
So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. And they'll get him down inside the 30 at the 27.
C.D. Lamb on the return. The Cowboys take over first and 10 at their own 27-yard line.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And their lead has evaporated in this third quarter. It's tied once more as they begin with a first and 10. Gonna look deep for Jeffrey. And got his man complete. And he will go out right near the 35-yard line. A big play that time through the air. 38 yards. And that is gonna do it for this third quarter of action. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. We saw a number of good games earlier today. This one might top all of those. It's been a dandy as we come up on first and 10. Throwing to start the drive, but that went incomplete.
The good signal callers would never go back in the huddle and play the blame game because they need those guys to protect him. But on that last one, his offensive line, they lost their leverage very quickly, and that's why they were able to get to him and hit him as he tried to throw the football and force an incompletion.
2 yards the loss, and now third and 12.
Aaron Donald's the name most people think about at the defensive tackle position, but an all-pro last year alongside him, Cameron Hayward, an absolute nightmare to try and block, and he gets into the backfield on that play and finishes it off with a loss.
On third down, it's Prescott. He's going to find his running back. It's complete. And he takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out. 13 yards and a first down, Cowboys.
First and 10 at the 24-yard line.
Prescott looks to throw on first. Oh, that was dangerous. Threw it into coverage, almost picked. But instead, they'll keep it on second down.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
From the 24, they'll go again on second and 10. To throw is Prescott. And it's caught. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. Terry McLaurin with his second touchdown of the game and fifth on the year. And the Cowboys have broken the tie. Here we go now as we get set for a big two-point conversion. To the air again, Prescott. And he is into the end zone. The conversion attempt is good. And that'll give him an 8-point lead here in the fourth.
Steelers 15. Greg Zuerlein, the kickoff for Dallas.
Now after the touchdown, it's Zuerlein. He'll kick it away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully.
25-yard ball. The Steelers take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. Still plenty of time here in the fourth quarter. Just a one-possession game, down 8. They'll be looking for the touchdown and two-point conversion. A field goal here on this drive does very little at this stage. Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete. George Kittle, the Pro Bowl tight end, the intended receiver. And now it's second down.
From the snap, he certainly looked like he knew where he wanted to go with the ball, but surprise, that guy was covered. So that took his attention elsewhere to no avail.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Going top shelf for Smith-Schuster. And that will be incomplete. Trying to dial up the long way out there, but it'll be third down. Big play coming up. Here's third and 10.
I would expect to see some pressure here.
And 10 yards to go.
The pressure drops off as they'll look to throw. And that's incomplete.
How about some applause for the defense there? They forced him to throw that one into coverage, and just like that, they're staring at a fourth down. Well done.
Fourth down.
One score down. Here we go. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. The Steelers will go. It's Roethlisberger. And no, it's incomplete. The Steelers try it, but they come up empty on fourth down. And Dallas, they'll take over in terrific field position.
The result of the play is a turnover on down.
They'll go with Pollard here on first down. And give him about 3 as he gets it down to the 22-yard line.
Tony Pollard, the ball carrier.
Brandon, you know how many times we've done games, and at the start of the fourth quarter, we see both teams hold up the four fingers, fourth quarter is ours. Well, how about this drive? You saw the four fingers for 4-minute offense. And this offensive line has really hunkered down and established themselves.
Now, this is where they say, put the game on our shoulders, we'll lead the way, right?
No doubt about it. And let me tell you, if you're a running back, all you want to do is get behind those big fellas, have a little vision, and find some space.
And a solid way to do that on the first play of the drive there. And he'll do a nice job here just to fight his way back to the line of scrimmage.
Take him down right.
No gain on the play there. Second down.
No gain on the play. Second and 10 at the 14-yard line.
Here's a quick throw out wide. It's McLaurin. And this play goes nowhere. Losing yardage back to the 15. Well, they completed the pass but lost yardage, so they'll decline the penalty.
Perfect play for them, isn't it? Who needs a penalty when you try and throw the ball, you don't even get it downfield, and they go ahead and snuff out the play. They'll take that as a result.
Prescott from the gun on third. Flushed out right. He may try and run for this. So no sack. He gets back to the line of scrimmage, but it'll still bring up a fourth down.
Well, there was pressure all around him, so the only play was to try and get out of there. I think it was an excellent effort by him just to get back to the line of scrimmage.
Zerline's kick is up and through. And that will extend their lead even further. A big one there. That gives them a little cushion and makes it a two-score game.
Yeah, bled a little time off the clock, put some points on the board. It's not totally out of reach yet, but it has to feel pretty good to them right now because as a defender, you go out on the field and say, guess what? You can put some points on the board, but that won't beat us.
At their own 25-yard line.
The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. And last time, went for it on fourth, didn't get it. We'll see if they can pick themselves up off the mat and do better this go around.
Sometimes I have this vision of coaches writing notes to themselves.
And he will go down, a Cowboys sack. Montez Sweat in there to take him down on what will take us to the two-minute warning. So the Steelers with the football as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Chidobe Awuzie with a pick. And a big return will get him all the way down to the 35.
Obviously disappointing, but you had to go for broke here, down two scores. So that forced you to make some throws you definitely wouldn't want to make. And I think this interception is going to pretty much write an end to this one.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. And I think this defense knew what was coming as he is smothered behind the line. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11. After the loss to start out, here's second and 11.
At the Steelers' 36-yard line.
Well, Prescott here to throw. Eluding the pressure right. And he whips that one incomplete there.
They certainly did a nice job improvising there, extending the play, hoping someone would come open downfield, but they never did.
And the 11.
On third down, it's Pollard. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 37-yard line. Now the Steelers use the first of their three timeouts as they get it with under a minute to go now in the football game. So out comes the field goal team now for the second time here today. This from 54 yards away. And Zerline's kick is good. And that will get the lead up to 14. So they settle for just the three, but clearly right now anything helps trying to salt this one away in the fourth.
Without a doubt, obviously a touchdown probably would have been the final nail to finish this thing off, but it still ate up time, got points. So while it's not mission accomplished, it's darn close.
First and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out there? Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. And all the way down to the 24-yard line.
James Washington.
A big play that time for Pittsburgh. 51 yards.
Steelers.
And that is incomplete. So 17 seconds now on the clock here. George Kittle, the receiver that he was looking for. And that'll bring up second down. From the shotgun, it's Roethlisberger. Letting one go deep for the end zone. And it's caught. He's got it for a late touchdown, but probably a little too late. It would take a miracle of epic proportions if they're going to pull this one off. Coming from where they were, they knew this was going to be tough, but they got the touchdown. Now they need the miracle, the onside kick and a little extra.
Yeah, and you have to hit the onside kick and not have the ball bounce around a lot and eat up time. You want to be able to grab it, possess it, and get your offense out there for what you just termed a miracle last chance.
And this is going to be recovered by the hands team. And that should just about put a camber on this one. In the fourth quarter, it felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of a anecdotal type of a number. Kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical.
Watch the pass.
The Cowboys on their way to victory as they take a knee. And now with 6 seconds remaining, they're going to burn their final timeout. So time to start going in the other direction as they come up now third and long. Run for Pollard. And he's going to be stopped here at the 43, and that is not near enough to pick up the first. So this one will end in a victory for the Dallas Cowboys. And it wasn't really always pretty. They had their bumps and bruises, really both sides did, but they did what they needed to do at home to get the win.
Yeah, they really had to grind this one out, didn't they? Because nothing came easy. Every snap was a major league brawl. They had to win at the line of scrimmage, win downfield. They got all those things accomplished. But to win a close one like this, you know, every team wants to be physical. We've heard that a million times, right? But those who are mentally tough, those are the teams that you have to deal with in the playoffs. This was that type of a game.
So for Dallas, the win will move them to 7-2 now on the year. And they'll be able to enjoy this one through the bye week before they get back at it again. Meanwhile, for the Steelers, they fall 2 games under .500 now at 3-5. And they'll be back home next week as they're set to take on the Cincinnati Bengals. And for Charles Davis and our entire crew here at EA Sports,
chains. I get through the pain. Taste sweet on my face like it's lemonade.
They say fall and you let go, but I know I got an antidote to retain some kind of self-control. Look inside my head through a telescope. You erase all the calls from a telephone. No sense of smile, maybe tell a joke. Holding back your tears, singing minimal syllables. Yeah. Look at me, at the asylum. Was a fate or mistake, cause the time ain't up. Yet the parts of my mind don't get much love. If you want in my head, come and call me up. You look like a twisted Robin Hood. Yeah, you take from the rich and the poor and us. Wearing diamond shoes where you walk your pugs. In a town you create where there ain't no love.
Where do I go? Chains, I get through the pain.
eyes drip out from the socket, so a teacup drink up inside. Look when they peep us. Jesus in the belly of the beast, but outside there's a war going on your front lawn. Black Hawk, see the red dawn horizon. Blind yet I'm rising, abiding by laws of attraction. My thoughts still rising. Thank you. What type of knowledge don't sink in? Life gives you lemons, and my only thought is drinking. Thirsty. Will I be alive or dead before 30? That's all that concerns me early. Lemonade quenching my inner rage when it takes center stage. Way before they pouring on my grave. Minute made, let it set my soul ablaze. On each and every way, put me in the water for the save.
They don't know my name.